This video is an addition to the previous videos we published about credential and visitor management. Here we only show what has changed since the new release compared to what was covered in the other videos. We will first show that there is a small change in how we configure mobile access from visitor and credential management. And we will cover a new feature in credential management called the two-person principle. First, let's take a look at what has changed in the mobile access configuration in the visitor and credential management settings. We let Charles log into credential management. Charles is the general manager of Roho Security and owns administrative access. From the settings, Charles goes down to the mobile access section. In previous versions of credential and visitor management, we were able to use just one line to refer to the mobile access backend. Since the new version, we find two lines here, one for administrative processing and one for registration. Both use the same address but a different port setting. The administrative port is now 5701. And the registration port is 5700. This is the same as the old situation. In visitor management, we need to use exactly the same settings. The two-person principle assumes that two people are needed to authorize a new user. The first user submits an authorization request. The second user approves or cancels. These are authorizations that are not self-evident and therefore require additional confirmation. In the case of Roho, this concerns access to the showroom and the warehouse. Both authorizations are given the status, approval required. This approval is only valid in credential management. Who will eventually become the requester and who will become the approver is determined by assigning a user profile. So we will create two of them. One profile for the requester and one profile for the approver. The following has been decided: Jet, our IT specialist, will create the users and provide them with credentials and authorizations so that they can at least enter the building. However, Jet cannot decide whether or not a new user will have access to the showroom and warehouse areas. He can only request that. So he gets the two-person requester profile. In the end, it is always Charles, our general manager, who makes the final decision. He will therefore have to grant the final permission that gives a user access to the showroom or warehouse. He is therefore entitled to the two-person approver profile. Gianna Garcia is going to start a big marketing campaign for which she needs temporary help. She found a young lady who is currently in her internship year at her business school to help her. Today this lady, named Nicole Blake, will join her. Jet Chen is our IT guy. He will enter her details in credential management and provide her with credentials and authorizations. The dashboard is somewhat confusing. Jet filters on colleagues and adds a new account. This is Nicole. Jet fills in her details as far as he knows. Nicole is there to help. Jet asks Nicole to download the mobile access app and log into the Roho Wi-Fi network. Nicole then opens the app to receive a new mobile credential. Jet activates the QR code on the screen so that Nicole can scan it in her app. She now has a credential and will also need authorizations. Jet can only be of partial help there. Jet can grant access to the building, but the other room where Nicole will regularly be, namely the showroom, Jet can only request. After all, he was the two-person principal requester for this authorization, which is valid until the end of November. He calls the boss to approve access. After all, Charles is a two-person principal approver. And once Charles has approved the authorization request, Nicole can continue on her way. She has activated the app and is walking towards the showroom. As she approaches, the door unlocks and Nicole can enter. Gianna is waiting for her and receives her. It is the first live meeting of the two women. So far for the two main changes in credential management. There are maybe a few more things that need your attention. First, there is the PIN code field that was missing in previous editions, and we also renamed a service. The identity server has been renamed to identity provider. This is all about the changes in AMS 5.5 and its additional software. We will continue to release new how-to videos with interesting or new features. If you want to stay automatically informed of all updates, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel.